If you've ever tried mixing oil and water before, you're well aware that it's not a spontaneous process. Thermodynamically, this tells us that the delta G for the process is greater than zero. So taking two separate phases of, say, oil and water, and mixing them together to produce a solution does not happen spontaneously and possesses a delta G greater than zero. Using some other experiments, we can determine that the delta H for this process is actually less than zero, and so it's exothermic overall, but it's endergonic, meaning that the free energy change is greater than zero. There's an equation that relates enthalpy and free energy, and it's delta G equals delta H minus T delta S. And taking that equation in conjunction with the two inequalities on the left tells us that the delta S for the process, which is the entropy change or the change in order, must be far less than zero. This implies that as a hydrocarbon dissolves in water, a more highly ordered state is reached. S is a representation of disorder, and so as we decrease S, we increase the order in the system. We can see how this works by considering the image at the bottom of this slide. In separating the hydrocarbon solute from the water solvent, we see that we have 6 free water molecules, and we have 10 water molecules that are bound up surrounding the hydrocarbon molecules. If we break up the solute and actually dissolve the solute molecules, this requires the involvement of 6 more water molecules in surrounding the solute. The involvement of those 6 water molecules implies a more ordered state, because those 6 molecules are not quite as free to roam as they are in the separated phase state. This unfavorable change in entropy is what drives the equilibrium of solvation of hydrocarbons in the reverse direction towards the separated phases. And this picture right here is very key in thinking about the aggregation of hydrocarbons surrounded by water. So hydrocarbons that are surrounded by water and forced to exist within water, for instance a protein in the cytosol, will be forced to curl up on itself because the hydrophobic portions of the molecule will tend to want to cluster together. This is called the hydrophobic effect, and it's one of the bases of protein folding. Hydrophobic side chains in amino acids on proteins will tend to want to cluster together, and this is why we see hydrophobic groups on the inside of proteins, where they can interact with each other, and hydrophilic groups towards the outside, where they can interact with the water solvent. This slide gives you a little bit of perspective on the weight and importance of the hydrophobic effect, and so you can see that Cosman in 1959 said that hydrogen bonding and the hydrophobic effect were essentially the only two factors that determined the overall configuration of protein molecules.